I think today if you ask me what leadership consists of, this is coming after, there's no Eureka moment. I would say one is passion for what you do, and two is the ability to motivate. As a trainee officer, I remember my first boss told me that there are two ways of working. One is you lead from the front, you work 24/7, you work very hard, you work yourself to death, and then you tire. The second is you build a team, enable them to work hard, give them the freedom, monitor them, and you just do the directions. And I strive very, very hard to do the second model, and it helps. It helps in the long run because sustainability is much higher. So I think leadership is about, how do you face adverse situations and still motivate your team. Build a team, motivate a team, and allow them to, achieve what you want the organization to achieve. Now, as far as men are concerned, I can give you one or two examples. I've worked in situations where my first post on promotion was as the chief executive officer of the Zilla Parishad in the district called Chandrapur, which is about, I think, 1,000 kilometers from here in the middle of nowhere. It was Naxal infested, and my boss told me, which idiot posted you there? I said, sir, it's the government which posted me there. So he says, no, I don't want you to be there. I said, no, there's no problem. In fact, what had happened the previous month was across the border, there were people, IAS officers, who had been kidnapped by the Naxals. So he says, you will get kidnapped. I said, but remember, when the Naxals kidnapped the IAS officers, the only person they released was the lady IAS officer to negotiate on their behalf. So here I was in this district, far away from anything, no telephones, remember, no internet, no telephone. So if there's a problem, if you get kidnapped, you think on your feet. Then you have to make sure your officers also are safe. You don't then just send them into the jungles and say, no, you have to lay roads. And apart from the Naxals, there were tigers. So they would come back and say, no, we went halfway and we saw tigers and we came back. So each situation, actually, you learn to adapt to that and you learn to respond to that situation, like she said. And actually, and you build upon your leadership qualities. That's, more recently, even after 20 years of service, I remember there was a scam in the government in the irrigation department, and they said they're looking for an IAS officer to head that because they needed to shift it from engineers. So they were looking maybe for a good officer, maybe for a scapegoat, but I actually took the challenge. That's the other thing. Leadership is about accepting challenges and saying, yes, what can I achieve through those challenges? The challenge was like this. The workforce was 40,000, all male most. There were only four engineers who were female. And the very first day when I went into office, somebody called me and they said, there's a huge write-up in the Marathi newspaper on you and they don't want you there. So the journalists came there. They're not journalists like Gayatri. They came there and says, ma'am, what do you have to say to this? We have an adverse report against you. So I said, yeah, I have no problems. I have no response to this. I'm okay with government is supposed to be. They said, no, but they've written against you, so what is your response? Now I said, please go through the entire article word by word. It's in Marathi, you understand Marathi. It says, Sanadi Adhikarichi Garaz Nahi, which means we don't want an IAS officer. It does not say that we do not want Mrs. Malini Shankar. Now, if they don't want an IAS officer, please go to General Administration Department of the government and ask them. Now, this is the kind of adverse position in which I entered when the entire engineering force, for whatever reasons, and there are multiple reasons, they were aligned against me. But I had to take them, build a team, take them on my side, allow their anger to subside, because after all, they've lost one post from the engineering side to the administrative side. You've got to understand that, you've got to understand their ego. I said, I'll give them some time. In the meanwhile, I will go and tour all the lovely dams and see what this job is all about. And they all fell in line. It was the most satisfying tenure I've had. So, it's multiple abilities, and over a period of time, over years, you acquire these multiple abilities to lead and to gain respect. The first thing that a leader needs is to gain respect. If you have the respect of people who work with you and work below you, who report to you, I think it makes life that much easier.